You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the SWN podcast. I'm your host as always, Billy, and something a little bit different, maybe a surprise to those that have followed the shenanigans of Scottish Wrestling Network on social media, but it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new era of respect, and I am joined by a past guest who's looking half a dapper as I sit here, actually cold, on an August after, mid-August day.
That's why this is on, I'm just freezing.
That is, I mean, it's annoying with this room. I'll introduce you in a second. But it's annoying with this room. It's a box room, so if I put on like an extra layer, I'll just sweat. But if I take off a layer, I'm freezing. It just doesn't work. Anyway, my guest at this time is one of the new management. I don't know if we'll find out what his actual job title is in a moment. But returning is Lord Sean Martin. Welcome back.
I'm so glad that Lord has stuck around for that long. I've not used it in, 2 years? And I'm still referred to as Lord Sean Martin. It is beautiful.
It was one of the best revelations that I've had on the podcast as I find out you were a lord.
It confused so many people when I started using it on shows. They were like, you don't present yourselves all around and go, yeah, but I'm actually a lord, and pulled out the card in front of everyone. And they were just like, oh, all right, cool. Yeah, sure.
As there was a good period where I referred to myself as Reverend Billy because I had one of those online ordainships.
I have one of those as well, and Dudism.
Of course. The big practice. Lies. That's the one. Anyway, I asked you off camera, but I'll ask you again so it's actually I've asked you properly. How's it going?
I'm tired. It's been a long 2 years since I showed my face in this, like, capacity.
Okay, what was the last time? Last time it was a day of birth bonanza, I think it was.
Yeah, that was before I officially went, yeah, I'm done for a while at least. That was like, I'm out.
That was enough. Appeared.
I was like, that's enough. That's plenty.
I remember he was on your year as
last
well.
Year briefly, and then just went, nah, I'm done again, and disappeared.
So I don't know if you want to go into the ins and outs of the hows and whys, but was there a particular reason why? It was just you stopped enjoying it? Was it just that was it?
I lost the time to be able to consistently train. So I was like, yeah, I can't keep taking bookings and not train. I'm not doing that. So I was like, right, cool. I'll take a break for a couple months. And that's just when Respect ended. I was like, take a break for a couple months. Get my life in order. And then a couple months turned into like a year, and I was like, I was meant to go back to that. And then I just kind of resigned to myself. I was like, yeah, it's probably not happening anymore. I was just like, I'm done.
So I mean, your last match I've got noted here is when you became officially in the wrestling world a laird.
There's two more after that.
Oh. So is one of them a gala, or
one of them is a gala? The other is Source's last show.
My guy who's doing the research has absolutely failed.
Was at the Battle Royal.
Was it just to be the last name in the main event?
Yeah, I made a quick blink and you'll miss it appearance.
My results guy's even worse. I didn't even get the names of the people in this. It just got Glenn Dunbar and Sean Fagan. Absolutely shocking. I'm going to have to fire that guy. So we'll talk about the last Respect show, and then we'll talk about the last Source show, because that's two fairly big milestones in a wrestling career. And then we'll actually dive into your new role as Respect Pro Wrestling. So it's got to be May. We won't count galas. We'll go for the actual people that are paying to see the wrestling, not just going, oh, look, there's a ring there, we'll go see that.
Joke's on you, I took money from the people at the gala to watch that. Fiver, come on, cough up.
Fiver, handshake, hot dog, just all the full trio, the triforce of British wrestling.
Absolutely.
So, Laird of the Ring, Frank Cross, Sean Martin, semi-main event, the penultimate match on the final official Respect Pro Wrestling show.
Yeah.
Was it an emotional night? I mean, you wouldn't have known at that point that it was the last show.
We did. It was Bobby had done the announcement about a month before that was it. Like, we were cutting it. He was done, and he was taking Respect with him. And I was like, oh, okay. Sure. It was really emotional. Like, everything. Like, I spent 4 years in that incarnation. So you kind of grow to love the people, the environment. And then sort of towards the end of the show, after my match, I was like, oh, this is it. Like, I'm not going to get this again. Mm-hmm. Like, this is impossible. Even if I were to go to another school and join another company, do the same stuff, it wouldn't feel the same. So I was like, oh, this sucks.
and that kind of didn't help with your decision of taking a break, I suppose, then, because you had that big emotive moment.
I was like, right, I'll take a break, try and get my head straight, sort my actual life out, and then I just never went back. Kept running into people when I was on like a night out or just in town, and everyone was like, so when you come back? And I was like, I can't be bothered anymore. Mm-hmm. It gets to that point where you're just like, it's so much effort to get back to where I was. I was like, nah, it's not worth it. All the sacrifice that I put through for 4 years, I was like, nah.
I mean, did you fall out of love with wrestling in general, or was it just the actual physical side of it that it was just not for you anymore?
It's not that it wasn't for me. Like, I'll put my hand up. I'd still happily do it all again. But I look at it as a very logical in that I cannot devote the time to training anymore. With work and everything else, I physically can't get to training consistently every week, once, twice a week. Mm-hmm. It's borderline impossible for me to do everything. So I was like, so either the fun thing needs to go or the way I make money needs to go.
Yeah.
And I was like, I can't do the fun thing without the way that makes me money. So it just never worked out again.
I mean, I absolutely understand that. It's real life has got to take over eventually. Yeah. I know for myself, I'm quite lucky. I'm quite blessed that I work from home, so I can do all my stuff here. This is where I do my work stuff. I do my podcast stuff. But even then, now I've got a 2-year-old as well. It's like, right, time has got to be found somewhere, and that's why I'm like, we're settling a date and a day. I was like, 8 o'clock must be 8 o'clock because I know that I was asleep.
I was like, I'll do it just as long as it's at night. I'll be fine. I was like, I can work around it. I plan my weeks the week before anyway.
Oh God!
Because that's when I get my rota for work, so I get it the week before. So I can't plan anything till I get that through. So 9 times out of 10, my next week is planned on like a Saturday night or a Sunday. So I was like, knowing this date going in, I was like, right, I can keep that free. That's fine, sorted.
I can't do it. I just can't imagine doing that. That kind of thing. It's like, again, lucky 9 to 5 I work and all that kind of stuff. So I like getting my chats and my bookings in like 3-4 weeks ahead, so I know that it's happening. Because otherwise, I'm just gonna be sitting here going, seeing like the Patreon episodes tick over, going, oh Christ, they've only got 2 in there. They paid £1. Oh. I want to get as much as I can. This is what I do, people. Patreon.com/ScottResnet. For £1 plus VAT, I panicked over not having enough content for you. But yeah, so that was a big emotional night. big night for Respect, and then he thought, oh, that's all right. I've had that big emotional moment, and then it was the last night of Source, the final chapter, being in that environment as well. So just kind of just trying to recapture the emotion.
I got asked a month before if I wanted to do it, and I went, yeah, why not? And I showed up, and everyone was so confused as to why I was there that I just kind of ran with it and just started walking around, saying, like, joining in people's conversations, just acting as if I'd been there the entire time, and just watched as, like, all these people got to have the night I had. When Respect closed, I got to be on the other side of that, to where I didn't have any attachment to Source. I was sad to see it go. You know, everyone that trained me pretty much came from Source. A lot of my friends and all that, Source. So, you know, it was sad to see it go, but I was like, this is their moment. I'm just getting to have a bit of fun and enjoy this again.
And you're still the lineal final Laird of the Ring, so
technically not.
Oh no, you got thrown out.
No, not even that. I technically dropped it to Lewis Gervin the week before on a gala day, which is what I consider my actual last match. Is a 20-second match with Lewis Gervin where I dropped the Laird of the Ring.
Wish I knew he'd won that before I had a big two-hour chat with him a couple of weeks back. That's
been a great topic. It's never officially recognised, but technically, on a technicality, he is the last Laird of the Ring.
So going forward then, you've had your big break. You're still a fan of wrestling. So so you're still watching it. Are you still keeping track of the indie scene, of the Scottish scene or anything like that, or is it just the big ones?
I keep up enough as to where I can slot things together. I was like, all right, cool, he's over there doing this and this, but he's also over here doing this. That's quite fun. I don't keep up as much with, like, anything overseas now. Like, I don't actively watch it. Again, I don't have the time, really. Yeah. And when I do have the time, I want to do anything else. I'm like, this consumed me for 4 years. Let's give this a break, and I'll watch highlights and scroll Twitter endlessly, hoping to see something cool.
That's my life as well. Yeah. When I'm trying to do other podcasts, or when I'm trying to sell myself to other podcasts, they're like, oh, do you want to talk about this pay-per-view? I'm thinking, I never watched it.
I've seen it. A couple of weeks ago, I was in work, and one of my customers, massive wrestling fan, he was asking me about a show, and I just, the whole time, I didn't have the heart to tell him I didn't watch it. So I just pretended as if I had. And I hope he never sees this, because I don't want to break his heart, but I never seen the show. I still haven't watched the show. I don't even remember which one it was, Billy.
I stayed up for, SummerSlam?
Yeah, I stayed up for SummerSlam.
I stayed up for SummerSlam just because, like, it's one of those where you hear the rumblings of what could happen. I'm like,
I always stand by I will always watch the big four. Give or take Survivor Series. Sometimes I don't, because it's Survivor Series, take it or leave it. And then I didn't watch it last year, only to be graced with the return of CM Punk, and was like, why didn't I watch it? I was like, the one time I don't watch one of the big four, CM Punk, hell freezes over.
That's the only reason I stayed up for it. That's the only reason I stayed up, because I was like, oh, God.
The whole day I was like, it's not happening. It's not going to happen. I wake up on the Sunday and go, ah, CM Punk's back. All right, that's great. Love that.
I mean, despite scrolling, like, as it was towards the end, thinking, oh, he hasn't arrived, and I saw Sean Ross Sapp, Christ, say that five times fast, saying that everyone's been cleared from Gorilla, and I was like, I think I'll just get myself comfortable for another 5 minutes here.
Watch this.
Let's do this. Well, you want it five, because I can't do it any higher, just in case I wake up the boy. So I'm just like, oh, come on. I'm not even that big of a CM Punk fan. It was just weird to see him.
It's so cool. It's like, you don't have to be a punk fan to go, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's something that punk's really good at. He transcends, literally going, I like him. It's just like, does some cool stuff.
It really is. I mean, people will argue to the death, but he is just as big, I think, for fans just coming into wrestling as a Stone Cold Steve Austin. Maybe a bit hyperbolic, because Stone Cold was just like a whole other beast, but I think when you see CM Punk, you go, all right, well, let's see what this guy's going to do.
Let's see this guy.
So from that point onwards, Respect was gone. Bobby had taken it. He had finished up his career. He's quite happily retired. He doesn't want to bring it back.
Oh, I happily retired, and I mean happily.
and then it was announced. I've got June 9th as the kind of reveal when the social media was wiped and then reactivated.
Yeah, not what even happened? Reactivated. That is a fresh start. Every single account was made fresh.
Well, that explains why I was looking to see if I could find the official announcement of when it was announced to be closed. So that's about a year then. About a year-ish since
2022.
I've missed so many years.
So just over 2 years, about 25 months.
So how did the conversation start? How did the Respect name get popped back into circulation?
Quite literally. And this is not exaggeration. This is not me downplaying it. Do you want it? Sure. that was literally it. We were joking around saying that I should run a show, and I was like, yeah. And then he was like, do you want Respect? And I was like, all right, go. Sure.
Well,
two weeks of absolute shenanigans trying to get everything in place to do an announcement. 3 weeks, actually.
That's mad. So, so literally just a conversation one day that I should do a show.
After a kid's birthday party that I was helping out at, sat eating some mozzarella sticks, Bobby has his burger, just joking around about doing something again for the annex and the local area. And then it just, by the end, somehow there was money out of my bank account, and I now had property.
Yeah, the Respect name, the belts, all that stuff.
Well, I already had the Laird. That was firmly sitting in my house the whole time. Never left.
I know. Lewis is going to be banging on your door now that he's heard this, that he's technically the champion.
I keep telling him that. I was like, Lewis, you're technically the champ. Do you want the belt? And he just keeps going, nah, just you keep it. I'm like, all right, cool.
Mine. One of those ones where you just, this is such a childish thought. Do you still walk around the house with it every so often?
Every so often I do walk around my room with it. I won't lie. I'll put on like some of my old entrance music, because I had six of them. And I'll just feel that feeling of what it would have been like to actually walk out with it.
I never got
to do it.
People, you could be a grown up, you could be in your 30s like I am, and there's still a rush about holding a wrestling belt and getting some music going and doing a bit of a strut, and it's still fun, and that's where wrestling should be. It should just be fun. That's the, except for yourself, because you've went from not having the time to watch wrestling or get to where you want to be in wrestling because you don't have to train
to going to run a company. I'm running the entire thing.
So someone who has never run a show, what was your kind of first port of call after you've?
Oh, what am I doing here? What have I done? Why am I doing this? First thing I done is wrote out a bunch of names. I just started listing, and I mean, this list goes on longer than the people on this card. So if you're not on the card, There's still hope yet. I just wrote out a bunch of names and started putting them together in fun little ways. and was like, oh, this isn't too bad. Oh, Billy, how wrong was I? How horrendously wrong could I have been? Very, very wrong.
It's one of those things where it's the Scottish scene is still very, very tense and everything. It's like you write down all these names, you go, right, and get them wrestling together. Oh, no, I can't. Or I can get them. No, maybe no, I don't want to have them on the card as well as that person. And it's just, I can't imagine how much of a nightmare it is. And then you've got to book them.
Yeah, yeah. So putting together the actual card was fine. It then came when it came time to actually book these people. And I think I booked them. So 9th was the official announcement. The 10th is when I started sending those emails and all that out. And I, off of the list of names and the pre-made card, had about 4 say they couldn't do it. And that's where the stress starts, when you then have to sort replacements, sort backups. That's where I realise, well, this is a lot of work. You can't just go, this is a card, and you're going to get everyone. You're not. You're really not. So then had to rejig, find new people who would fit in these spots with what I wanted. And would it work? I got there eventually.
And you got a nice and tidy little card that here as well. So Bobby's kind of not involved with the running, but he has the venue. He's very involved with the Community Annex.
He's the venue. We're fundraising the entire thing for the youth drop-in at the Annex. Mm-hmm. He's been trying to raise money for it for months, so I thought, hey, you know what, this is what this will be for then. It's a nice little thing. It's my way of giving back as well. Like, the Annex holds such a special place in my heart. I was like, nah, I want kids to be able to come here as well and feel like this place is special. Because it really is. It's a building in the middle of nowhere where so much has happened. Mm-hmm. It's quite an incredible place, and I don't want the youth drop-in to lose out on that. I want them to be able to have fun. I want them to have a place to go on a Friday night when they have nothing else to do. Like, there we go, oh, the youth drop-in's on, let's go. So, yeah.
I mean, the venue for wrestling itself, it's seen some of my names that have went on to do things like ICW and all that kind of stuff come through. And it's certainly, it's quite a important place for wrestling. And I'm just looking through some old cards here, and I'm seeing the likes of Jack Morris has made an appearance, who of course is killing it in Japan right now, and quite possibly will be winning the N1 by the time we're speaking.
Oh, who knows?
That would be absolutely mad if that happened. But no, you've had the likes of Aspen, who, oh, there you go. That's the mention, was that 25 minutes in? That's not a bad run. Jokey, KOE, it's been an absolute stellar list in there. So when you're putting together the card, then you put your names out. It's like 4 didn't make it. That's fine. They might make it the next show. But when you're putting together, so there's a lot of names here that have been part of Respect in the past. Get to their actual matches in a bit. But like Emily Hayden, like Lewis Gervin, Taylor Veit as well. But a lot of new names, quite a few guys from like Girders and Beyond and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So with your kind of keeping an eye on the scene, seeing where people are and all that kind of stuff. How did you kind of throw some of these names in here?
So a lot of them I already knew, obviously, through like working with them in the past, working on shows with them. And then there was a few that like so Jack Ripley. I'd never seen him work until last year when I was at the last Source show. And I seen him and I was like, he's fantastic. I like that. The others, like, through pals, like Robbie Cardwell, seen him work a lot of the Girders folk. I was like, And I kept up with girders. I kept up with GPWA. I was like, right, keep an eye on everything. Because, again, I still had that thought in my head of, I'm going to go back at some point. Mm-hmm. So if I knew who was coming up, I know who I was going in with. Rather than looking at all the big names and going, oh, I'd be there. It was like, no, I know the process now. It's like, these are the names I'm going to be in with. I'm not going to be in with the likes of big names. So I was like, look at the guys coming up through the scene. So again, that was what Respect was about. It was giving everyone a chance. The new names were all like, these are the people that are going to do well. Even the names that aren't on this show, that I was like, maybe an art hour, are still going to do fantastic. Yeah, it was simple a case of, I was just like, I like these people. I'm interested.
And quite a few of the names that you've thrown on here are very in tune with things like social media as well. So
yeah.
It also couples with the fact of, great, you've seen these guys you possibly will have worked with, or never say never, could still happen. But knowing that these guys are going to sell your show as well, they're going to go online, they're going to go, I'm in this match, I'm here.
They're really going to push it.
So we'll jump back and forth to your Respect life now, and we'll throw into a match as well, just to keep things fresh. So for those unaware, we're half an hour in ish. Respect Pro Wrestling have got a show on September 14th at Lochwinnoch Community Annex in funnily enough, Lochwinnoch. A show called We're Back Again. Sometimes it's called Oh My God, We're Back Again. I got really confused when I was doing the
full name is Oh My God, We're Back Again. But when I asked the guy that was doing the poster if he could put that, he was like, it's too much to fit in the thing. Like, we're going to have to split it up a bit.
Mm-hmm. That's fine. I put We're Back Again. So if anyone's checking the match announcements, that's what it is on our site. So there's six matches announced. Someone has also been confirmed for the show, so I don't know if we'll find out in this re-chat what they're going to be up to. Doors open 6 p.m, bell time 6:30. Tickets available through Respect Pro Wrestling's Facebook page, which is at RespectPW. That's Papa Whiskey, our working insurance. I know the phonetic. So you can go and check out there. You can get your tickets and come along 14th of September. I have a look at my week calendar here, and I think there's only one other show on that day. So, you know, I'm probably wrong. I'm very out of date with my calendar, but at the moment, I've only got one other show in that date. So apologies to, like, I always miss Target. Unfortunately, I always miss Target. It seems to be the one they run a load of shows, and I'm like, oh shit, they've
got so many shows.
But anyway, so go back on the calendar. There may be like loads of shows, but at the moment there's two.
Yes.
So if you're not in the Dundee area, go to this show in Lochwinnoch. You know, that's what you should do. Whoa, 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 there, Billy. You have absolutely made a mistake. So on the calendar, when I did this recording, I had an event that's actually not taken place on that night. It's taken place like 2 weeks afterwards. So I was totally incorrect. There's no shows in Dundee that day. As far as I'm aware at this moment in time, there may still be. Keep an eye on the calendar, swnscotland.com, under feature promotions, under promotions list. There's a tab. It's fine. It's cool. But there is a show that day. There's a doubleheader. Blade and Gums Wrestling have their two shows. Their two shows at Kirkcaldy and Beveridge Park Hotel. So I was technically right. There is one other show that day because Blade and Gums are running that day. But technically they've got a double header of a show. So if you want to go see some deathmatch wrestling and see some stuff like that, fantastic. Kirkcaldy is the place for you. If you want to see some Respect Pro Wrestling, if you like the card for the show, head along to Lochwinnoch. And go see that show. I'm not your mother. You go buy your tickets. You go enjoy your wrestling. The only way you know how, and that is just by buying your ticket, heading along, and just enjoying yourself. So back to you, Billy. You absolute idiot. Anyway, first match I've got is just, I'm going to go down the list here. Casino Brutal. Speaking of guys that are fantastic at social media, Casino Brutal, Rabu, and Mikey Devine will be taking on Taylor Veit and David Devlin. So, yeah. David, again, another name that is very synonymous with Respect Pro Wrestling.
Yeah.
A former Respect Pro Wrestling champion.
No, he never won the belt. He was in the match that Aspen won the belt.
Of course.
I know this because I was the referee. And I counted that.
There we go. So anyway, my fact checking is doing absolutely abysmal tonight. I'm glad you're here to keep me right. I'm not speaking to someone else, and then you're in the YouTube comments going, "You're wrong, you're wrong, you're wrong."
That'd be so funny.
I'd put it out live just every 2 minutes it comes up, 14 minutes.
Me retweeting it going, "This is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong."
God, I mean, it would drive my engagement. I mean, I don't know. I don't know how I would feel about it if I look at it in the morning going, "Oh my God, there's 10 comments from Sean." And then I look up and go, see my engagement's gone through the roof. I'm like, oh no, the balance.
Pros and cons.
So Taylor Veit is, again, someone who has wrestled a couple of times. Yeah. And I love Taylor Veit. I love him where I would strangle him. But
I don't like him at all, and I have strangled him, and I can tell you, Billy, it's very therapeutic. It helps a lot with the mind.
It looks like, we're not condoning violence. It's a wrestling podcast, of course we are. But I love him as a character. I love everything he does in the ring, but I would gladly watch him get beaten up.
Oh yeah, I'd gladly do it again.
So David Neville, bet through Source and all that, and Casino Brutale, who have just won tag team gold as we're recording.
Yeah, they won
the Community Pro Wrestling Tag Team Championships, which I was kind of gutted by, because it means I can't put them on my tag teams to watch next year, because they've won gold now. oh, apologies. But one of the best tag teams going right now.
Oh, absolutely.
And you put them with two very straight-laced individuals, Taylor and David Devlin. So, yeah. Was this one of the matches you were like, yes, this is what I want straight away, or is this possibly one that you had?
So... I had Casino. I was like, great. And then my original plan for their match fell through. And for days, my email and my messenger had just been blowing up entirely with messages from Taylor just saying, book me, you coward, book me. Just all sorts of... There was some explicit language used, I won't lie, Billy. So eventually I caved. And he said, I'm bringing someone with me. You better have people for us to beat. And I was like, well, funnily enough, the stars had aligned, and I found two people that no nonsense in Casino Brutale, absolutely none. And I get to have, well, not exactly a front row seat, you know, I see quite far back, but I get to watch them beat Taylor Veit heavily. There is no love lost there. Absolutely none.
As the beauty of a promoter being that you can book someone to watch get beat up.
Absolutely. I can just keep doing this until he eventually learns his lesson. I don't think he will.
The next show, Taylor Veit Gauntlet. Everyone you can get booked on the day. Taylor Veit, that's your opponent for the night.
I've
seen the cogs whirring straight away as soon as I've said that, going, yeah.
You're getting an angry email off of Taylor now. You're threatening with lawyers.
I'm sure he will. Not enough. Like I said, not enough good words I can say about it, but at the same time, not enough bad ones as well. But that's a cracking match to put in just straight away. Like I say, Rabu and Mikey Devine are just incredible. I'm still yet to see them wrestle, which is so irritating. I've never seen them wrestle live yet. So
Billy, well, there's a perfect opportunity on September 14th in the Lockwin at Community Annex at Respect Pro Wrestling. We're back again.
Convenient.
Things available through Respect Pro Wrestling's Facebook page.
Doors open 6 p.m. apparently. Bell time 6:30. People should really jump on that.
Exactly.
Affordable tickets, I'm sure, which I have not got. I've got the poster in front of me.
£10. Children are 8 in a family of 4. Two adults, 2 children for £28.
Bargain. Absolute bargain. People
should absolutely
getting in touch. Not like seeing some of these ticket prices going through the roof when you're getting 6 matches, possibly 7 matches, guaranteed to be an absolute blast of a night. So tag team match, done. Tick that one. As much as preview, this is how the preview's going. 3 minutes of us going, that looks like a good match, eh? Yeah, it does.
That's great.
this is going to be wonderful. So following on that, then, I'm going to pick out Just the second one I've got on my list. I'll forget one otherwise. We've got Fraser Gervin versus Craig Forsyth. So, yeah. Craig, another one who's hung about that kind of area
Someone
for a long time.
I'm extremely excited to have back. I love being around him. He's brilliant.
And Fraser Gervin, hadn't even made his debut when Respect closed, because he made his debut at Final Chapter.
His debut. I was there behind the curtain, grinning ear to ear, watching him.
He's just a guy that, from chatting with him, it's been a long time coming, that kind of debut.
Absolutely.
Have you kind of seen his development? Because, of course, you would have been close with Lewis as well.
I've seen a bit of it. He was briefly at Respect with us. And then, obviously, Respect closed. So he was going sort of between us and Source. When Lewis would come down and all that, he would come down. So I got to see some of him, and I was like, how's no one put him on a show yet? And then a year later, someone put him on a show, and I got to watch that and finally see his effort of God knows how long pay off. And that was something really nice to see. It was like, it does all pay off.
I compared him, I was speaking to Lewis, I compared him and both of them as as the Hart Foundation, because Fraser's that kind of unpredictable Neidhart kind of role. You don't know what you're going to get with him, because you can see clips of him doing all this kind of cool agile stuff, agile things, and then you see him just throw someone. And I'm just I don't know what to expect.
I've likened him to a pit bull in the way that he is absolutely terrifying. He is fast and strong, and I'm not going near that at all. I don't want that smoke.
So Taylor, that's your next. That's the next show.
Taylor. Fraser and Craig. That'll be very exciting. Fraser keeps claiming that he's going to be everything his brother was in the original Respect. So, who knows what attitude he's coming in with? I'm assuming not the nicest to deal with, but. I think he'll be firmly saddled beside his brother.
Yeah, we'll definitely speak about that match in a little bit. So to kind of wheel back, under new management, that suggests that there's more than one person, or is it just you? Are you the guy there doing everything, or have you got a setup?
New management refers to sort of everyone helping me do everything, because as we explained earlier, I don't have the time. So there was no way I was going to be able to do everything myself. So there is a couple other people helping me out. I won't name names because we all elected the person to be the face of everything, and somehow that was me. Not sure how. They're helping with stuff like socials and keeping an eye on folk because I don't go to shows much anymore. I might do now that I have a reason to. So I kind of need someone who has that knowledge of who's actually putting in the work, who deserves it.
Yeah. Yeah, a bit of scouting.
A talent scout.
Yeah, we'll call them that as well. So they'll have the little clipboard that shows near you, just to keep a track of
who. Yeah. Monocle,
That's it. Little earpiece, just relaying to nobody. There's nobody there, but you got to look the part. I got to get the tracky suit on,
Yes.
So we'll dive into another match. Then we've got Emily Hayden versus Ellie Armstrong. Again, another one. Emily, very much a
Both.
Key part of Respect. Ellie towards the end as well.
Ellie, So she was Return of the Lord, November 2021. Where she was in a team with Hayden. We got to that point, I have no idea. Ellie's attitude's changed over the past couple of years, as many can see. And Hayden didn't like that as much. She wants to sort of keep her place intact. She wants to keep, like, she is the princess of respect. She forever will be. She wants to keep that. Mm-hmm. She wants to show that this is her domain.
Emily's been one, she's been a little bit quiet at the moment. I don't know if that's a scary thing to consider, where she's during that time.
That's terrifying. As someone who speaks to her almost every week, that's terrifying. Mm-hmm. If you don't hear from her, be concerned slightly about what's about to happen.
I think the last thing I saw with Emily was she was putting out videos about being the final boss or the final girl boss of professional wrestling. So if that's what's coming to Respect on September 14th, tickets still available.
I hope not. My insurance won't cover that.
I know, that's the fun things you have to think about now as a promoter.
Insurance. Oh my.
Oh God, I've worked in insurance for 17 years. It is never going to get any more exciting. But against Emily Armstrong, who, yeah, depending on what day you've got her, it's either going to be a nice,
lovely flower power or
militant vegan.
I don't want to say it.
Oh, that's all right. She'll tell you.
Yeah, but that's the thing. I don't want to say it because, you know, she'll have, I'll be in arm's reach of her in September. So I really just don't want hit.
Yeah, I mean, that's an absolute joke, of course, because I love Ellie Armstrong. If you give me a list of names, I'm
Keep backtracking.
That's all I'm going to do in the podcast now. I've got to backtrack. People get offended. I'm turning to Rogan all of a sudden with the beard and the hair going, woke. Wrestling's gone woke. But no, I'm a big fan of Ellie. Hopefully we'll have her on the podcast as well.
Absolutely.
Emily is just one of those names that I don't think's had a fair shake in wrestling, and I'm hoping that this return in Respect will pick that off. And like you're saying, it's a case of Respect was always about bringing in people that you wouldn't normally see. It gives them a little bit of a new playground to become
themselves, work some different people that they're not getting to work other places.
Because going through the names, I remember like Judas Gray and Rob Stowe, they had their first match in Respect.
Yeah.
And Judas now.
Brilliant. Phenomenal.
And Rob's doing great stuff in Discovery Wrestling as well. He hasn't quite broken out yet, but he's always...
He'll get there.
He's going to get there. And brought guys down from Keith Ness, and who you wouldn't see anywhere else. And brought guys up from
Newcastle,
brought them up. Yeah. We had that thing with Uprawl as well. So there's always been something going on at Respect, whether something unexpected, which is probably kind of within your plans to have something unexpected. That doesn't make sense. That's an oxymoron. But we'll say unpredictability. Thy name is BT Gunn. So that was just announced today, I think it was this morning as we're recording, that BT Gunn is confirmed for Respect Pro Wrestling. Another guy, much like Emily, much like Elliot, they've got these two sides of the coin. You can get just us, jovial BT Gunn, who's just come for a good time, do a bit of a spin-a-rooney, chop someone, you know, have a good time.
Yeah.
Or you get the psychopath.
Or you get the oddity.
The oddity, yeah.
Yeah, again, my insurance won't cover that. So I'm hoping we've got the Just Us version. Please, please, please.
But we don't know what it's going to do. I don't know if it will be announced by the time this episode goes out, which I have not told you when that's going to be.
That's a surprise.
It's going to be in a couple of weeks anyway. End of August is when it's due to go out. So if you haven't announced it by then, keep an eye on social media, everyone. Respect PW. I'm assuming it's probably, if it is going to be announced, it'll be announced by now. But, you know, get a ticket. So BT Gunn, a guy you would have not only, I don't know if you share the ring with BT Gunn, but you would have seen him wrestle a hell of a lot.
Oh, yeah. I don't own the t-shirt anymore. My mother owns it. She took it from me. I still own one of his t-shirts. I own, you know, all sorts. I love BT before I even step foot in a ring. So to be able to go, I've just booked someone for a show that I loved to watch, that's insane to me. It's very surreal.
Mm-hmm. I mean, and also from a logical standpoint, as a guy that's very well, much at the top of the pecking order in Iron Girders, who does a lot of the work for Iron Girders, also kind of nurtures that relationship between the two, between yourself and that school, and you've got a few guys that are through Girders anyway, so that's a nice thing from a logical standpoint. But then again, you could watch the oddity absolutely blister someone instead.
Please do.
Have you named, as I know they've got the gorilla position, I can't remember what the AEW call theirs, but I'm assuming yours is called the Roberts position or the Bobby position. No, I can't call that.
No, I don't want to give that man any more ego.
Fair enough.
It's just called, where's Sean? Oh, he's over there. It's just over there to me. I've not named it yet. It's just over there.
Sean's crying corner.
No, that's separate. That's another.
Is that where your insurance documents are? Is that where the event insurance is sitting? Just so you can read it through, going, oh no. There you go. There's the promise. We didn't say how it was going to cry, but
I did say I'd cry.
We don't know what BT Gun's going to do, but BT Gun's going to BT Gun.
Well, I do.
Well, you hope. You hope you know what he's going to do.
I know what I want him to do. Whether he does that or not, it's a different story.
Yeah, so just make sure you have Taylor on hand, just in case, you know, just shield.
It's going a bit nuts. Taylor, you go get him.
You only know that I'm the face of this. Taylor's the assistant to the... go through him. That's probably the
best.
For all
you know, Taylor's actually, like, the owner of Respect. I'm just his puppet.
The thought of his hand going anywhere has terrified me. So let's just move on. Speaking of that Iron Girders connection, you've got Chris Kingston coming over to Respect to take on Jack Ripley, who we've mentioned. Risky Jack Ripley, who may or may not have his Risky Business tag team partner in nearby.
Unfortunately not. He wasn't available.
Terrible. Absolutely terrible. But Risky Business, great team. They've certainly captured... Absolutely. They're charismatic. They're interesting.
Very charismatic.
But we've got half them, which is still going to be interesting, charismatic.
I will say this. What you see on a show is them in real life. That is constant. Constant.
I can confirm, as having them on the podcast, they are... Yeah. Chaotic. They are chaotic. I think
it doesn't stop.
It really doesn't. I think we had to go into some sort of very weird cancelable tangents during it, because we just kept going and they just kept chatting, and I was like, yeah, I don't think I could. I mean,
cancelable tangents on this podcast are my thing. If we remember what we almost titled my interview,
I can't remember offhand, but I know it wasn't good.
It was not good. We ain't gonna say it on this. We don't need cancelled this time.
I think that was a couple of weeks after I did the Big Benny one, where it was titled on Patreon Big Benny 2, a podcast about Marissa Tomei's boobs. So, you know, I was having a very
fun time.
I was having a very fun time. Now I don't have fun. This is a job. I've got Patreon. Yeah. I've got £1.20 to earn from all my patrons. Chris Kingston, Jack Ripley. Chris has turned out to be quite a weasel in Iron Girders as part of the court of King Moxie. But he gets the job done. He's won a fair few matches. And Jack Ripley from GPWA, nice little clash of GPWA and Iron Girders at the same time, which is the schools you're keeping an eye on.
I'm keeping an eye on every school, but it just so happens that these are the ones I've picked from, because these are the people I knew.
What was it about Chris Kingston that caught your eye?
Again, that same feeling I have towards Taylor. Of just, I hate you. You're not a nice person. But I didn't know that was just down to being around Moxie. So I was like, all right, well, I'm going to take you. Just you. And I'm going to bring you over. Because I want to see if that attitude is just because of nature versus nurture. I want to see if that's just the nurture or if it's his nature. Whether he is this conniving weasel, or if he's just a nice guy. I'm probably highly wrong. He's probably awful.
I guess what are those? Oh man, Chris Kingston, Taylor Vite's getting a lot of mentions in this. Chris Kingston,
he really
Chris
is.
Kingston,
I don't
Taylor
like him.
Vite, just getting them in the same venue as each other. That might not be the best idea on your part.
Yeah, probably not. But nah, I'll learn.
That's fine. Again, Chris could be one of the benefactors here. We don't know. You're not going to tell me, so we don't know. There'll just be another one to send Razor to or BT to. You know, just
yeah.
They handle the finances. They've got the handshakes and the checks. You do that. But bit different. Chris Kingston's more of a technical wrestler from what I've seen, and Jack Ripley is a very much a high flyer.
Very much fly. I just want to see what they will do to each other.
And then we've got Darren J. Blair taking on Martin McAllister, and there's a couple of matches here. I'm like, oof. This is one I want to see. Darren J. Blair, Martin McAllister is one of them.
Yeah.
Because I love Martin. Martin is.
Yeah.
Sometimes he goes to places and he hangs out with Ellie Armstrong and it gets a little bit too vegan-y. But.
Yeah, I've seen that. I was concerned.
But Martin is an absolute. He's patient as a saint, beautiful human, does a lot of good stuff for wrestling. And for just being a nice person.
He does.
And Darren J. Blair, possibly, again, another guy that is just on the cusp of breaking out
just
somewhere.
Just on the cusp of absolute brilliance.
And so
I
this,
want to push him over that edge.
This felt like a no-brainer as a match goes. I mean, you've also got Darren, I think, still the Scottish Junior Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, so he's still the Junior Heavyweight Champion.
And we've got Martin McAllister, who's the Iron Girders champion as well.
Champion.
So that's quite a combination you've thrown in there. Again, it's a very common question with these kind of going through previews of shows and stuff like that. Is what was the thought process? Was it just we saw them, no brainer, put these two together, it's going to be great.
So when looking at it, I had Martin in mind already because Martin's brilliant. Martin's a great face. To like have on a poster, I don't actually think he's on the poster. Whoops, but he's a great person to have around. He's a great energy to have, and I thought, what is the complete opposite of that? Someone filled with hate and spite. Enter Darren J. Blair, someone I've known for 3 years. So, again, I've came up with him, never shared a ring, but I've seen him. The last source show, he worked David Devlin. And I watched him let out a lot of anger. But I could see there was still some of that remaining. And what better than to put anger against positivity and just see what happens. This whole show is very much, let's just see what happens if I do this.
I mean, the match that you've put together as well, I mean, is it going to be a couple matches in before you think, yeah, okay, let's get another date booked into wherever, where it's the annex again? Is it a sink or swim, this show, for whether you do a second, or is this now what you're
putting? No, I think I've locked myself in. Like, there will at least be one more. How many I can deal with, I don't know. No, but I truly hope that it's very much a swim. And not even just a swim, I hope it's a sail. I hope it's just get back in the boat and it's not got any holes in it.
I mean, if it does, hopefully there'll be plenty of people there to kind of fill them.
Pick up my pieces as I'm an emotional wreck.
Sorry, you got a corner for that. And the final match that we've got announced for this show is Lewis Gervin, the lineal Lord of the Ring, as we've established on this podcast, taking on Robbie Cardwell, a guy who really was starting to rise up through respect, and then he's now King of the Fling. So we've got a Laird versus a King here. Lewis Gervin, King of Robbie Cardwell.
I'm still the respect Laird of the Ring, so please. Actually, no. All the belts have been vacated. That is something huge. First thing I done is I sent messages to every champion, apart from the tag ones. I'm sorry about that. And just vacated everything. outright. Everything's fair game. It's just when I decide to bring them all back.
That's it. I mean, none of the titles are on the line as you've announced so far. Who knows? There's still time for a change of heart. Whether you wake up one day and go, you know what? I think this match is going to be.
I can know what, Billy. I'll give you a clip. The main event is for the heavyweight title.
Is that Garvin Cardwell?
Garvin Cardwell.
Oh, yes. Lewis has been a guy that has just kind of reinvented himself after the pandemic. He took his time away and came back, and he's just him and Fraser are just an absolute beast of a team. Again, yeah. The fact that they're both in the same venue is maybe concerning for Robbie Cardwell.
This whole show is concerning, but yeah, for Cardwell especially, that's not going to be the most fair fight. I don't anticipate it being fair at all. I have plans. I have plans in place to even those odds.
There it goes. Just the teasers. You gave me a little, and you've just teased it back, reeled it back. Just been an hour of respectful teasing. Six matches that you announced again. We've got BT Gun confirmed. For those that I've somehow forgotten, it's September 14th, Lochwinnoch Community Annex. I just like saying Lochwinnoch. It just rolls off the tongue right nicely.
It really does, doesn't it?
It does. Tickets available through Respect Pro Wrestling's brand new Facebook page. I'm sure if you contact them through Twitter, you might be able to
get Twitter, a response. Yes. You might be waiting a while because I don't often check the Twitter DMs. Better going through the Facebook, it goes straight to my phone and I'll get back to you.
There you go.
Depending on when you send that message, probably immediately.
There you go. Respect Pro Wrestling Facebook, go get your ticket. £10 adult, £8 children, family four, two adults, two children, £28. Doors open 6 PM. Get your ticket because I don't want to use some cliches, but it's a bang tidy card.
It really is.
Because there's a lot of names that you may have seen through things like the WWE Network when Chris Martin made his debut through that. Ellie Armstrong appeared on there.
Emily Hayden was on it.
Emily Hayden, of course, as well. And Casino Brutale, I think they made a couple appearances. And
Casino, maybe just towards maybe the end of the Network.
Taylor as well, I think, towards the end. So I think he was with ADM.
He appeared on ICW on the first fight show, I'm sure. Or was it the last? Oh no, it was the last Fear and Loathing on the Network.
There you go. So WWE, the fact that you haven't, the fact that you, as a promoter, you haven't put the WWE symbol on the poster is.
That's because none of them have been signed yet, Billy.
Yet. That's
the moment they get signed, that logo's going on right next to their name, and it's just like I'm gonna milk that dry, everything it's worth.
As soon as they get signed, you'll be at their door with the 8x10 saying WWE Superstar.
Yeah,
sign these, please. We've got raffles to.
I'll be like, when's your contract officially start? I want one last date out of you.
But so that's it. That's the whole card, as we know, that's been announced as of now. You've already teased some surprises coming up. We know that there's going to be a championship match, Lewis Garvin and Robbie Cardwell for the Respect Pro Wrestling Heavyweight.
I should probably tell everyone that I actually announced that and put something official out.
I mean, this episode isn't going out till the 30th, so if you wait until the 31st, that would be wonderful.
Absolutely. You know what? I'll do that just for you, Billy. I'll wait till the 31st.
I get the exclusive. That's it. But no, I don't want to like say good luck and put some added pressure on you, but as we're a month out as we're recording from the show, when is the reality going to kind of set in that, oh my God, we're back again?
I genuinely think about 5 minutes before the show. I think I will be don't get me wrong, I will be stressed that whole day trying to get everything sorted. I don't think it'll be 5 minutes before whoever's music hits first, and I go, oh, this is happening. Oh, oh, I'm doing this. All right, okay, let's go.
It's an amazing thing. I couldn't imagine the stress. I've always had the, you always have the wee match cards. Even now, I put together wee match cards going, oh, that would be amazing. And then I think all the logistics that go behind it going, oh, how am I going to afford this? Where am I going to do this? What's, when am I going to get a ring? Oh, no, I have to get referees. Oh, no, I have to get insurance. I am surprised that you seem so calm, even though probably inside, behind that respectful wrestling jacket. Yeah, you're just like, we're going to stop recording and you're just going to take like 5 minutes. Going, oh my God, I've spoken about it now. It's definitely happening. I can't just delete my socials.
Yeah, no, I genuinely think that this as well was kind of one of those moments where I was like, oh, this is happening. Like, Billy's messaging me again. Oh no, what have I done?
I to be honest, I didn't think I'd get a response. That's why I went for you. Because I thought, I might not get a response if I go through the respect page. Because I didn't know who was in charge. I thought, yeah, you've been heavy plugging it. So I'm thinking, Sean has something to do with this. Sean's nice. Sean will speak to me.
I'm awful, Billy. This is all fake.
I'll take it. You know, as long as I'll take you slagging off behind my back.
Skinner back in a room together and see what happens.
Skinner might need reeled back. He's starting to come along to himself on these podcasts. He's interrupted many a podcast recently. And last, I don't know if you saw Last Day of Birth Bonanza, but he spent a good 5 minutes slagging off everyone to their faces in the Zoom call. It was a moment in time.
He's such a gem of a human as well. I love him.
I know. It's
I get almost, on so well with him.
It's almost like the duality of man. You've got Taylor Vite on one side, who you love to just throttle. And the other side, you go, yeah, Ian Skinner, who's an absolute chaos, a captain of chaos. And then you look at him and go, oh, he's really nice.
He is really nice.
Joking. So going forward, you said there's possibly one more in you to do, and
possibly
then we'll see from there.
I don't want to have to, but if a situation comes up to where I have to put my boots back on, I will.
You've read my mind. That was my question. It was going to be, is there a chance we'll see the return of Lord Sean Martin?
I would rather not, but if someone pushes me enough throughout respect and I feel it's necessary to get back in and show everyone why I was trusted, I will. This is a threat.
There we go. That's, I mean, you've got a lot of big characters coming to this show. September 14th, doors open 6 p.m, 6:30 bell time. Get your tickets through Respect Pro Wrestling Facebook. Now, so for now, we've ended it with a threat. I think that's possibly not the way we should end a podcast.
That's absolutely the way we should end the podcast.
I think that maybe mirrors nicely the last time we had a chat, and I'm going to go revisit the episode to find out what we were going to call it, because I know it was something.
Oh, don't worry, I'll fill you in.
I hope it's not that. But for now, plug the socials, plug all the respect stuff. I mean, we've done a pretty good job plugging the respect stuff tonight, but yeah, one last sale, throw it in. Ah, there we go. Fantastic for the audio.
Respect Pro Wrestling, September 14th, Lochwinnock Community Annex in Lochwinnock, funnily enough. Tickets are £10 for an adult, £8 for kids, £28 for a family of four, which gets yourself two adults, two children. One child goes free. Their accounts, Respect Pro Wrestling on Facebook, Respect PW on Twitter, and Respect Pro Res on Instagram, because everything else was taken.
I think it's like three Respect Pro accounts hanging about somewhere. But wonderful. Thank you very much for taking the time to speak about Respect Pro Wrestling. We're probably going to have another half an hour chat afterwards, just slagging everyone off. But in the meantime, this has been good luck to the show. For the show, it's going to be a wild night, I'm sure, for Respect Pro Wrestling in Lochwinnock. And fantastic lineup. Go check out all the socials. Check out our website as well. We'll try and keep you up to date. And we've already got that exclusive. Lewis Gervin, Robbie Cardwell, Respect Pro Wrestling, the Heavyweight Championship is on the line. New champion will be crowned. Let's go, Slag folk. Let's go. Let's go.
Absolutely.
Right. Enjoy, everyone.